أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأقرب ذكري بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصل اللهم على محمد وآله الطاهرين اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم آمين رب العالمين. I begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the compassionate, the merciful. Inshallah, and tonight we'll start a series of lecture about understanding and getting deep into the concepts of understanding, the importance of understanding Al-Quran Al-Kareem, the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah verse 185 says, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. So we know the Quran was revealed in the month of Ramadan. Then if we come to Surah Al-Dukhan, verse number 3, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إن أنزلناه في ليلة مباركة. We have revealed this Quran in a blessed night. So now we know it came down in the month of Ramadan and in a blessed night. If we come to Surah Al-Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines this night. It says, إن أنزلناه في ليلة Qadr, we surely have revealed it in the night of power. So we know this Quran was revealed in this month. How we can make use of this Quran? What's the importance of understanding the Quran and the dimensions we can make use of? This is introduction number one. Introduction number two, we know the Quran was revealed in Arabic, and it's very important, and it's very important, and I stress on this point that we should learn Arabic. Now, these days, technology is easy, YouTube, applications, Saturday schools like they do here. Everywhere you go, you can learn and pick up Arabic. Arabic is a rich and enriched language. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Yusuf, verse number 2, it says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, inna anzalnahu Qur'anan arabiyan, la'allakum ta'qilun, so you may reflect and comprehend and think and take this information. As Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, under the explanation of this verse, he says, the Quran in Arabic are the words of Allah. Learn Arabic because was revealed to you by Arabic. These are the two introductions. We come back now to understand the importance of understanding the Holy Quran. Because again, as we mentioned, there are many, multiple different dimensions we can benefit from. The first dimension is for those mufassirin, interpretations of the Quran, they need to have a solid foundation that when they want to come and understand the Quran, they have a big solid foundation. They can understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to tell us from the verses of the Holy Quran. And the second dimension is to understand the Quranic concepts and all the information that was revealed in this Quran and all the other knowledge that has been revealed to us through this holy book. Now the question that may come to us, what is the benefit? Is understanding the importance of understanding this holy Quran? Can we use intellect? Do we use tradition? Do we use other methods to understand the Quran? What is the method, how we should come and deal with the Quran, how we should understand it? If we go back to the Quran itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nahl, verse 16, بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالزُّبُرِ وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have revealed this book, this scripture, بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ, with clear proofs, that you can reveal to people what has been revealed to them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ. So this tells us that the Quran reveals to everything. مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. We have not let anything outside this book. It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has encompassed everything in this book. Again, if somebody asks, this is not a math book, this is not a physics book. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي. This is a guidance book. يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ. It's a guidance book. It's addressing the souls. It addresses how we should live happily in this life and in the hereafter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now to understand the importance of knowing and understanding the Quran, it lies in two reasons. Reason number one, we want to understand the importance of knowing the Quran would be to prove the miracle of our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. As we all know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent prophets and messengers with miracles to prove that they are connected with heaven. They are been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we know, Prophet Musa with his stick, Prophet Isa curing the dead and the blind, and so on. And when it comes to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to prove his miracle, we can use this Quran to prove the miracle that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is connected with the sky. If we come to Surah Fussilat, Surah number 6, verse number 41, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Qul innama ana basharun mithlukum yuha ilay." Yuha, it means revelation, it means I'm connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's very important to understand the Quran so we can prove that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger, is the one who come with this complete message, the message of Islam. And as this miracle is this everlasting miracle that runs day and night till the judgment day, muhaiminan alayhi, so it overcomes all the previous scriptures and the books that has became before him. So it's very important to understand this point, because as we know in other verses, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Isra, قُلْ لَإِنِ اجْتَمَعَتُ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. If mankind and jinn come together to come with the Quran like this, they will never be able to, because this is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in order to understand the power of this book, the divinity of this book, we need to know the importance. It's been revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is proof number one. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us another proof in Surah An-Nisa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عَنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Shall they not reflect upon this Quran, and if were to be from other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will found many miscommunication with this Holy Quran, within incongruity within it. So this is the importance number one, is to prove the miracle of our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second reason of the importance of understanding the Holy Quran, as we know, we have the traditions, we have the ahadith from Ahlul Bayt, from the companions. As we know, other school of thought, like the Sunni school of thought, they depend mostly and heavily on the companions to take their narrations to get to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they say all the companions are udul, which we don't agree on, because the Quran itself shows there are some good companions and some munafiqun. وَمِنَ الْعَرَابِ مَرَضُوا عَلَى النِّفَاقِ لَا تَعْلَمُهُمْ نَحْنُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ ارْتَدَّ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ. As in Surah Ali Umran, verse 144, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٍ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ انْقَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ عَقَابِكُمْ وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبُ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا وَسَيَجْزِي اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. If the Holy Prophet dies or he killed, you will turn back into your heel. It means turn back. It means you leave Islam and you turn back to the ignorance time where you came from. So the Quran clearly shows that the Sahaba, the companions, are different lovers. And as we know, there is an entire surah on Surah Al-Munafiqun that we recite on a Friday day. So now we have this huge heritage of traditions, of ahadith, of narrations from our school, from school of thought, from the imams, from Ahlul Bayt, from the Sahaba. We have this huge tradition. How shall we deal with the huge tradition when we know there's some misinterpretation, some has been forged, some has been played with, some was transmitted by meaning? What is the source and what is the reference to filter and clear out these traditions? So the second reason comes the Quran. We come back, we use this Quran because in traditions, in the hadith, we know there's Alm al-Rijal, there's the science of man, where they say, okay, this narration has been translated from An Zurara, An Muslim, An to Imam al-Sadiq. So we come to the science of man, Alm al-Rijal, we study these men. Are they authenticated? Are they trustworthy to take this tradition from? So every tradition we have to filter it out. This is Alm al-Rijal to show you that the series connecting, relating this narration is authenticated. Now how about the content of this narration? Now we're talking about, okay, it got to us through these men. How about the content, what they have revealed? Is this content correct or not? So in order to understand the content, we come back and refer it back to the Holy Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا يَأْتِيهُ الْبَاطُلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ. It's not like the tradition, it's not like the narration. Somebody heard it, he understood it, something, and he transmitted it in another form. No, لَا يَأْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ تَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ حَكِيمٍ حَمِيدٍ. It's related from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we come to the sanad who narrates the Quran, it's truly frequent related to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's no doubt with that. So it's a reference. It's a major reference for all these ahadith, all these traditions and narrations that we can refer to use the Quran as a reference. So this is the second point of the importance of knowing the Quran. And now to prove this point that we come to the Holy Prophet, from his narrations, he tell us to go back to the Quran. I'll list some of these narrations due to the shortness of time. عن أبي عبد الله الإمام الصادق إن على كل حق حقيقة وعلى كل صواب نورا فما وافق كتاب الله فخذوه وما خالف كتاب الله فدعوه. So Imam is giving us a formula. Any narration comes to us, refer it back to the Quran. If it agrees with the Quran, take it. If it's not, let it. So this is a reference we use to filter out these narrations. عن اختلاف الحديث إذا ورد عليكم حديث فوجدتم له شاهدا من كتاب الله أو قول من رسول الله فهو الذي جاء به. Another one, ما لم يوافق القرآن فهو زخرف. If it does not match with what the content of the Quran is, this is not what we said. And so on. خطب النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وقال أيها الناس ما جاءكم عني يوافق كتاب الله فأنا قلته وما جاءكم يخالف كتاب الله فلم أقله. Anything, any narration that we get from the Holy Prophet and it agrees with the Holy Quran, then the Holy Prophet has said it. Otherwise, the Holy Prophet did not say this narration. And so on. And the Holy Prophet, he mentions, he talks about the fitna. He talks about the persecution. فقلنا يا رسول الله, the companions asked, كيف الخلاص؟ فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم بكتاب الله, by the book of Allah. فيه نبأ من كان قبلكم ونبأ من كان بعدكم وحكم من كان بينكم وهو الفصل ليس بالهزل. So the Holy Prophet continues on and describes the power of this Quran الذي لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ومن خلفه, that in every fitna and every time there is something going wrong, go back to the Quran. This is the source. إلا بحبل من الله وحبل من الناس. And this is in Mustadrak al-Wasail. And so on. And it's nor إذا التبست عليكم الفتن كقطع الليل المظلم فعليكم بالقرآن فإنه شافع مشفع وماحل مصدق وما جعله إمامه قاضه إلى الجنة. Whoever puts it before him, it means if I use the Quran, if I take the teaching of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and apply it on myself like Ahlul Bayt, like what they did, then this Quran will guide me to the heavens. And so on. As in فضل القرآن واعلموا أن هذا القرآن هو الناصح الذي لا يغش. It's the advisor that does not cheat you. والهادي الذي لا يضل. And it's the guider that will guide you. And so on. وما جالس هذا القرآن أحد إلا قام بزيادة أو نقصان. Whenever you sit down with the Quran, you'll either get an increase or decrease. Increase in guidance and decrease in ignorance. Because we are sitting with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every time, like my sheikh teach me, he said, when you sit down with the Quran, clear your mind. See what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to tell you. استنطقوه. Ask the Quran, take the information, read between the lines. The Quran, this is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّهُ مَنْ شَفَّعَ لَهُ الْيَوْمَ الْقُرْآنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ شُفِّعَ فِيهِ وَمَنْ مَحَلَ بِهِ الْقُرْآنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ صُدِّكَ عَلَيْهِ. So again, as I conclude, the reason of importance of understanding the Quran lies within two main reasons. The first reason is to prove that it's the miracle of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi. And the second reason is we use it as a main reference for all the traditions that we get, that we refer to the Holy Quran, and whatever matches with the Quran, we'll take it, and whenever not, We'll leave it alone. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وآخر دعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصل اللهم على محمد وآله الطاهرين اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم.